energy supplies are crucial for security, security written by big S. And I think that energy sources, energy supplies, routes, and general diversification of those is crucial for our security, security of our nation states. Security, energy security is responsibility of national states governments only, uniquely. This is like that in European Union and globally the same. So if we are talking about energy security, we are talking about something essential for us. And Russians, they know it. And they know it very well. So they use it. They decided long, long time ago, during Soviet times, to weaponize oil, crude oil and gas supplies to Western countries, to Europe. This is very long, stable strategy, executed very well with those pipelines circling Central Europe, entering Germany, delivering gas to France, Italy, from different sites. Western European economies started to be hooked to this Russian weapon. In 1990, some of very prominent people from Politburo, Russian Politburo, publicly they wrote in a German newspaper that they were going to replace tanks with pipelines, just to secure Russian domination in the region. Knowing that, I no dare to say that crisis, I mean gas energy crisis, which was started last autumn in Europe, started by Russian maneuvers on the market, was a preemptive try. They wanted to show us, all of us in Europe, how dependent we are on Russian supplies. And really, we are. So they threatened us. They persuaded European governments to treat those, I mean, lacking by in October, November, December, Russian supplies and something needy. And now we are discussing sanctions. We are discussing sanctions and we are trying to persuade, at least we in Poland, we are trying to persuade our partners in Europe to impose sanctions, embargo on gas and oil import from Russia. But the governments in Europe already know, it was shown to them how vulnerable they are. This is one of the reasons why these discussions on sanctions are so hard and we are not able to reach agreement on that. But if we want really make a difference, if I may say, in context of war with Ukraine, we have to hit Russia really hard. And if we are not able to do it by military means, because of series of reasons we know, Let's take this one which we have. The great part of Russian budget revenues comes from crude oil and gas selling. Even more from crude oil than from gas. It's easier to replace crude oil supplies because we have a global crude oil market. These days, the International Energy Agency, convenes in Paris. Not many people remember today that this body, this agency, was started after oil crisis in 1973, just to give security of supplies to everybody who would like to be part of it. And this is for the agency and member of the agency producing oil to be persuaded by us to raise production and to replace globally Russian oil in the market. And this is part of this discussion about sanctions. This is for us, for our governments, to really try to achieve this goal. Some nation states, some states, member states in the European Union are better prepared for this move. Some are less prepared. Some of them, like Germany, made great mistakes. I believe they were mistakes. Because, you know, the meeting in 29 September 1st on Westerplatte, part of Gdańsk, where Second World War started, was a meeting attended by Mr. Putin, Chancellor Merkel, but it was hosted by our late President Lech Kaczyński. And Putin addressed directly Merkel sitting in front of him, describing new axis, Moscow-Berlin axis. Not only proposing this axis, but describing existing already cooperation above our heads. Not only Polish, above other European heads. President Kaczyński answered, rejecting such a strategy, such a format for cooperation and security and sphere of influences in Europe. But, you know, this cooperation between Russia and Germany is not only former Chancellor Schroeder or second Nord Stream pipeline. They symbolize this cooperation, but it goes far beyond. This is why there is no clear stand on war in Ukraine in Berlin today. This is dangerous. This is dangerous because our cooperation between free nations is endangered. And this is the major strategic goal for Russians. Undermine our solidarity. Start hesitations, quarrels even, divide us on the West. We should support Ukraine every mean we have, also energy means. We could suffer. We'll be suffering. We'll have to pay for it in money and sometimes probably less heating. but we should do it. Because on the other side, there are people dying and fighting for their freedom. And for Poland, but I believe not only for Poland, the very existence of Ukrainian states is crucial for our security and our independence. Thank you very much.